Hi guys, it is me, Chazzer HD, and you may be wondering why have I uploaded this video only, you know, a couple hours before the Japanese Grand Prix is supposed to be taking place, and why am I uploading a video when I'm supposed to be doing a race stream? And you may be also wondering why I didn't do my qualifying stream. Well, this video is going to explain why. Hopefully I don't go too long with what I'm going to talk about, but I think this has been something that's been coming for maybe the last year or so, you could argue. I did talk about this at the Miami Grand Prix last year, that I was losing passion and interest for just what was going on. And even though, again, as we talked about at times, you know, towards the end of last season, we did have some better racing in the second half of last year, from what we've had so far this year, it just isn't doing it for me, Formula One in 2024. And really, I would say that is the number one, but not the only reason why I can announce that I will be taking a step back from streaming. Is not the right way of putting it, but probably doing less streams this year and a lot less watch-alongs this year than originally planned. Because, as I said, Formula One just isn't doing it for me at the moment. I haven't fallen out of love with Formula One. It's just Formula One today and the Formula One we've seen for the last year, year and a half, maybe even 2 years, you could say, just hasn't been, 80% of the time, just hasn't been worth watching, let's be honest. Let's not try and make it sound like Formula One has actually not been that bad in the last couple of years. It's been, and it's not because of Max Verstappen and Red Bull, trust me, it's not. We've had dominant drivers, dominant teams in the past, you know, Hamilton and Mercedes, Vettel and Red Bull, Schumacher and Ferrari, and you can go back to, you know, dominant periods in the, you know, 20th century as well. It's not because of that. It's because not only when it comes to the fight for who's going to win the race, but just really throughout the top 10, it doesn't really feel like there's a lot of competition going on. You know, you've got Red Bull, of course, the best team. Props to them, full credit to them. They're an amazing team, and, you know, they're going to win the championship this year and next year as well. And then you've got Ferrari and McLaren, who are competitive to a certain extent. That's probably the best battle, really, at the moment in Formula One. And then you've got Aston Martin being carried by Fernando Alonso. That's the only reason Aston Martin are relevant in 2024. And then you've got Mercedes-Benz, who are a complete joke and are an abomination, really. You know, only before the Japanese Grand Prix, what, 26 points on the board? After three races? That is absolutely horrendous. They're closer to Racing Bulls in sixth than they are to Red Bull at the top after three races. It's, you know, just a complete joke from Mercedes-Benz. And if you look at the racing so far this year, it just hasn't been very competitive. We haven't had really a lot of battles on the track. Races have felt like they were basically done by the time we got to like lap 25-30, when there was still, you know, another 30 laps to go. And like I said, Formula One just at the moment, and maybe, you know, this will be a thing probably until 2026, we'll have to see, just isn't doing it for me anymore. This is, again, it's not a permanent thing. I'm sure if, you know, we get a lot better racing, competition, and just a lot better of a Formula One in general in a few years' time, I'm sure that I will feel a lot better about Formula One going forward. But yeah, when I came back to streaming in 2021, after having in 2020 a, you know, massive mental health crisis, you guys, some of you, you know, longer listeners and subscribers will remember that. I made a promise to myself not to do streaming or any content on the channel that I didn't want to do. And I think I've got to that point where, because of the lack of competition and my own lack of interest at the moment in just what's going on, I don't want to do watch-alongs for Formula One right now, because we basically know going into every weekend at the moment what's going to happen. Now, there's going to be certain weekends this year where it's, you know, properly competitive. And for those Grand Prix, I will probably do live streams. You know, Monaco's one where it's always competitive. You never really get a team dominate around there. Monza is one where I think it could be very competitive. I'm sure there'll be other Grand Prix as well where it'll be competitive. But with the tracks coming up, you know, obviously this track this weekend, the Shanghai circuit in a couple of weeks, then Miami, I just don't see really, you know, if we're going to get anything worth really watching at the moment. That's the first and the biggest reason why I have come to this decision to, again, massively cut back on streaming. Other reasons, though, is you guys may know, beginning in, what was it, September of 2022, I started a university media course, and I'm still on it. I'm going to be doing a bachelor's in this coming September. And with my progression on that course, I have now started, where I'm basically at the very, very start of a possible freelance media career, you could maybe say. We'll see how it goes, we'll see if I'm actually able to make it something. But with YouTube, you know, doing live streaming, I love doing streaming. I absolutely love doing it. It's, you know, when I do content on YouTube for the channel, it is my most favorite thing to do. But again, if the races are regularly just below average and, again, not really worth watching, there it doesn't feel like much reward really at all for doing those live streams. And as well, I'm going to be totally honest, my, you know, live streams, they don't earn a ton of money, and it isn't worth, I think, the maybe as much of the commitment that I was originally wanting to put forward into those, given the reward or lack of reward I'm getting back in terms of, you know, not getting great racing and great entertainment out of Formula One, which, you know, nothing I can control there, but is what it is. And yeah, that's, you know, another big reason why I've, you know, come to this decision. And I'd want to have, you know, for what I'm doing with freelancing and that, I want to have more time to do that. And I don't want to be doing live streams covering races and qualifying sessions and just F1 weekends in general that are not really that interesting or exciting in reality, when I could be better using my time to, you know, go out filming or editing something and maybe earning a bit more money doing that. Yeah, so that's another reason for, you know, the decision I've made. So again, recap, I am going to be cutting back on streaming. Not sure really how much I'm going to be cutting back. I think at the minute, my plan is I'm going to do qualifying and race watch-alongs based off of whether we actually, you know, whether it actually looks like we're going to have proper competitive racing, and whether it looks like we've got like a good weekend or good race or good qualifying session in store. You know, if we get to the next Grand Prix in China and Ferrari and Red Bull are separated by a tenth of a second the whole weekend, then I'll stream for qualifying the race, no doubt about it. But if Red Bull are miles clear and then you've got the other teams, Ferrari, McLaren, Mercedes, not really racing each other that hard, then I'll give it a miss, because again, I don't think it's quite worth the amount of commitment I, you know, was maybe previously willing to put forward there. But also, Another thing I want to mention, and you would have seen with that Lance Stroll video that I did back in mid-December. It was like 10 days before Christmas, I think. Obviously did very well, over 100,000 views, the highest viewed video on the channel. Even, I think, if you look at like the old channel, even though the old channel doesn't exist anymore, I think it's even one of the highest viewed videos it would be on that, if that was still around. And really, that is more so the direction I want to take the channel in. I want to do proper edited content and proper, I don't know if you'd call it documentary type content, or just, you know, going over stuff in Formula One that is, you know, some of it up-to-date stuff about current situations, whether it's drivers, teams, or controversies, stuff like that. But also, you know, stuff in the past that I want to cover as well. And I've got plenty of ideas for that, and I'm way more excited about that than I am doing a qualifying or race watch-along for a race that, you know, I already know basically what's going to happen. So I think going forward for the channel, that is basically the plan. I'm going to try and, you know, once I finished my second year at uni, which I should be finishing by the end of May, then over the summer, I'll have quite a bit of time to properly work on longer edited videos for the channel, which I'm going to do and try and get, I don't know, ideally at least a couple videos out, say during the summer break. And then, like I said, when it comes to live streams, it will depend purely on whether it looks like we're going to have a competitive, exciting weekend. With the example, you know, that I got into earlier, you know, if at the top, if it's looking very close, then I'll cover it. But if it, you know, is one team dominating, and below that it's not really that close between the other teams, then, like I said, I'll give it a miss. And in general, with Formula One, a lot of the issues I've got is stuff that I've already talked about. These cars are too heavy. They're too wide. They're too easy to drive. I mean, if you go look at Max Verstappen's onboard pole lap of Suzuka, he doesn't even look like he's pushing. Of course he was, but it doesn't even look like he was. And it's because these cars are so ridiculously easy to drive. That, you know, even just watching the cars by themselves is not as interesting as it used to be. And as far as I'm concerned, Formula One right now, in terms of the on-track product, whatever you want to call it, on-track, you know, action, entertainment, it's the worst it's been since I started watching. I can't remember a time it's been this consistently average or just bad. The last season I can remember, the last time period I can remember that was this bad was probably 2015, where we had regularly that year, you know, really poor or very average races. But even in that year, we still had the occasional classic race. If you look at the last year and a half, even 2 years, how many classic races have we had? How many genuinely great races have we had? This feels like since 2021. And obviously, you know, what made 2021 so exciting was the Verstappen and Hamilton battle. And, you know, obviously that ended in controversy. But it just feels like everything Formula One related since then has gone completely downhill. And if you look at viewership figures for Formula One in terms of, you know, TV viewership figures and social media interactions for Formula One, it's all massively down on 2021. So I'm not the only person that feels this way. There's plenty of people, you know, that feel this way. And there's plenty of people that either are, you know, having a break from watching Formula One or have just given up completely. I'm not going to give up completely on Formula One, because when we get to 2026, a completely new era, we could be back to what we got in 2021. If we are, then great, and I'll be, you know, covering it you know, every Grand Prix and all of that once again. But with the current state of Formula One as it is, I'm just not going to be covering it on stream as much as I was, you know, as much as I was previously. And as well, you may, I mean, when did it start? It was like midway through 2022, almost a couple years ago. What do you call it? I started doing a lot longer streams. Instead of like 2 hours, it'd be like 5 hours. And a lot of the reason I did that is because Formula One, even in the first half of 2022, but obviously on the back end of 2021, it was, you know, the feeling around Formula One was very good. And it was exciting enough that I could do those very long streams. And even though, yeah, they are very tiring once you get off stream and all of that, whilst I was doing it, I was having so much fun because it was genuinely really, you know, fun to do. Because really, you know, the on-track action was very, very good. And that is the number one, you know, thing that we want at the end of the day. So, yeah. But before I go, just want to say, you know, apologies to you guys for announcing I was going to do content and not doing it. Again, apologies for that. But I think it would be very insincere of me to do a live stream and do it whilst not wanting to do it in reality. I can't bring myself to actually do that. So that's why I'm not going to do that. And like I said, made a promise to myself a couple years ago that I'm not, if it stops being fun, I'm not going to do it anymore. And at the minute, it's not really fun anymore, but we'll see in the future what happens. Let's hope things get better. Knowing me, the Japanese Grand Prix is probably going to be really exciting, and I don't know, McLaren are going to win it or something crazy. But even if they do, I think, you know, going into the race, if you look at the starting grid, I think I am probably in the right for expecting it to be a pretty below par race where nothing really happens. The only thing really to look out for is, will Charles Leclerc finish in the top five? That's it. Everything else doesn't really matter. So, yeah. But, again, apologies to you guys for, you know, letting you down when it comes to that content. And as well, if you're disappointed by this and you want to, you know, unsubscribe or whatever, or stop watching, it's your choice. But I just want to make it clear that I'm not quitting the channel. I'm not quitting streaming. I'm not quitting making videos. I'm cutting back on it because at the minute, like I've said a million times in this video, it just isn't fun right now. Let's hope the, you know, the most important thing when it comes to Formula One, the on track action, let's hope that improves to the point where we can get regular competitive races. I don't care, as I've said a million times, I don't care who wins. It doesn't matter to me. All I want is competitive, exciting races. Doesn't have to be necessarily, you know, who's going to win the race. Doesn't always have to be about that. But if we can get back to that on a regular basis, no matter if the championship's being dominated or not, then that would be great. And let's hope we can get back to that pretty soon. But in terms of when the next live stream will be, like I said, it will depend on if it actually looks like we're going to be in for an exciting qualifying or race coming up, you know, in the next Grand Prix in China. Again, if it doesn't look like so, then I won't be streaming. But if it looks like, you know, at whatever Grand Prix coming up, if it looks like we're in for, you know, a properly good weekend or race qualifying, then I will announce as soon as I can on my channel page, my community page, and on my Discord server as well, I will announce that I'm going to be going live. So don't worry, I will let you guys know as soon as possible. But most of you are going to be watching this after the Japanese Grand Prix. I hope it was a great race. I don't think it probably will be. I think it'll be probably like a 3 or 4 out of 10, realistically, if you look at the starting grid. But hopefully it's a good race. Hopefully you guys enjoy it. And until the next time I see you guys, which will be either in 2 weeks, 4 weeks, or whenever. But I will see you guys again, no doubt about that. Sooner, hopefully, and probably rather than later. But yeah, hope you guys have a good rest of your Sunday. And until next time, it has been me, Kazza HD. Goodbye.